You cannot imprison a people's desire to be free forever. The Pharaoh's heart may be hardened 10 times. And I'm submitting that Paul Biya is a latter-day Pharaoh. His heart may be hardened. He may hold the view that he will use the instruments of terror to terrorize the people of Southern Cameroon into submission. But let him be reminded that Hitler thought so. Let him be reminded that Idi Amin thought so. Let him be reminded that Mobutu Sese Seko thought so. Let him be reminded that Jean Bedel Bokassa thought so. Let him be reminded that Hissène Habré thought so. Let him be reminded that Mengistu Haile Mariam thought so. Let him be reminded that Ali Bashir thought so. And they all ultimately surrendered to the will of the people. I have no doubt in my mind that it shall come to pass. And I know that it shall come to pass sooner than you realize. You know, it is very easy, and I've heard some of those who do not believe in the crusade that we are carrying on for the people of Southern Cameroon say, how can you possibly be talking about the unity of Africa, and yet you are speaking about the self-determination of the people of Ambazonia. I'm telling such individuals that self-determination and unity are not mutually exclusive. Africa will be united, but she cannot be united under false peace. There are two kinds of peace. There is the peace of the graveyard. Nobody wants to be in the peace of the graveyard in a cemetery where there is silence which is unproductive. People can only engage in peace where there is respect for their dignity, where they have the opportunity to realize their potential. It is our duty, therefore, to make our own contribution. You know, when the leadership of Ambazonia was abducted in Nigeria, it must have been in the mind of the Biya administration that that was the death of the struggle of Ambazonia. But I want to submit to you, time has demonstrated again and again that those who are in positions of leadership are merely the arrow's head. And that the true leaders are the people who are assembled here, and the men and women who are in ground zero, who are prepared to make the ultimate sacrifice with their lives. I have no doubt in my mind, as Nelson Mandela once said, jail is the university for all who seek to serve. The men who are now in jail, the pain notwithstanding, are going through education of an exceptional kind. They are being prepared like all men have been prepared throughout the ages. And you are out here, you who by God's grace and by your own strength are gathered in this foreign land, as was said, you have come here for a purpose, and you are the guarantors of the peace. It may sound peace, it may sound painful, it may feel painful, but I have no doubt in my mind that your hearts remain unsettled. Because it is true, no matter how comfortable you are in a foreign land, you are never settled. You are never ever settled. The peace that you think you have is only deceptive, and your presence here is a testament to the fact that you truly left South Cameroon, but South Cameroon is within you. Ambazonia is alive in your minds and hearts. And you know, I remember in 1994, I was a young lawyer, and I remember when it all started in Rwanda, when the perpetrators of the Rwandese genocide deluded themselves that that they could have something in the nature of a final solution by slaughtering the Hutus, the moderate Hutus and the Tutsis. And for 100 days, they killed and maimed. Many a commentator wrote the obituary of Rwanda. The world was silent. The United Nations was silent. The African Union was silent. The African leaders were silent while genocide was being perpetrated. Today, the United Nations is silent. The African Union is silent. African countries are silent. African peoples are silent. And another genocide is in the making. But let me tell you, they can only be silent for so long. It is our duty, therefore, to shout from every rooftop, from every forum, within and without the continent of Africa, to remind the world that in a place called Ambazonia, genocide is being perpetrated. It is our duty to remind the world that things called elections may be held, where winners are known before the votes are counted, but that those sham elections will not solve the problem nor immunize the choreographers, that ultimately the truth will rise. Because truth has this habit that it never dies. Truth has this character that it remains alive for all times. So, fellow Ambazonians, because all of us must share in your problem, it is our solemn duty as Africans to go around the continent, and we will go around the continent, even when we are stopped occasionally sometimes. We will walk to every capital, and even if we don't, wherever we are, we must go to the universities, we must go and use every forum that we have to remind the world that the people of Ambazonia are being massacred and slaughtered on a daily basis, and the time has come for the world to rise, and that the world must now begin to speak about the question of Ambazonia and their right to self-determination, and latter-day doubting Thomases who think that this is a battle which will be concluded through military action will discover to their shock and chagrin at once that it will not happen. Therefore, we who are here today, one of the things that we must remind ourselves, that it is at times such as these that the enemy whose agenda is to destroy you will want to sow seeds of discord. They will want to confuse you. They will want to infiltrate you. They will want to demonstrate to you that you are incapable of recognizing that which is in your best interest. Let us defeat them by showing them that we are united in our agenda and that we shall never be divided. Throughout the ages, those who have identified their mission, those who have identified their agenda, those who have remained true to their cause, those who have been prepared to fight, those who have been prepared to sacrifice, those who have been prepared to do things not for their own benefit, have always succeeded, and I have no doubt in my mind that you will succeed, and that the images that we see here, the men and women whose lives are being rudely cut short, that their lives will not have been lost in vain. That their lives will be the price that we have to pay, and that those who are perpetrating these heinous crimes will be called to answer, as indeed history has demonstrated, that there is a time for reckoning. I have no doubt in my mind that one day, and I pray and hope that during our lifetime, the Biyas of this world will be asked to answer, and that they shall pay for it. Many have thought wrongly that they are larger than life, almost larger than death. But the truth is, They are deluding themselves. The truth is that this administration, which will shortly be announced to have won that which they lost, will sooner realize that that victory is a Pyrrhic victory. They will sooner realize that they are in the last leg of the perpetration of their diabolical scheme. They will sooner realize that young men did not die in vain. They will sooner realize that the more you kill, the more you create. They will sooner realize that the people of Ambazonia will not surrender. They will sooner realize that you can arrest and kill, but the more you arrest and kill, the more you energize the people's spirit. People of Ambazonia, some of us who have chosen to be the mouthpieces of your cause, we shall remain up. We shall go and use our energy and give voice to the atrocities that are being committed, so that those who have conscience, their conscience will be pricked and the conscience of the world will be pricked. Do not feel tired. I know sometimes some of you are in a state of depression. There are those of you, and it is normal, who feel, why should I waste my time? You are not wasting your time. There are those of you who feel, why am I supporting a cause where whose end cannot be predicted? Do not feel tired. There are those of you who think that the enemy is too strong. Do not feel tired. Those of you who read the Bible, the only reason why David killed Goliath is because while everybody thought that he was too big to defeat, David knew that he was too big to miss. And I have my own conclusion that indeed, that is how we should feel. So we must, in the nature of things, embrace the spirit of David. And I have no doubt that it shall happen. Mr. President, I know these are difficult times. And let me remind you that when you are in a position of leadership, the only thing that you must expect is criticism. That is all. If by chance anybody praises you, thank God. Leadership is not a bed of roses. Leadership is about being insulted. Leadership is about being accused for every offense known to us, except the crucifixion of Jesus Christ. So be prepared, but even in the face of such pain, soldier on, because you have men and women who are supporting you. Some of them will be in the forefront with you, some of them will be in the background, but it's true that all hands must be on deck. And as we are in ground zero, those of you who are pursuing the legal arena, those arenas are arenas that we must also fight in. We must fight everywhere, because ultimately victory is guaranteed. Yeah.